So, the Olympiad questions. Question number one, if you see.
Excuse me, sir.
So, how can. So, they have asked. The given diagrams, compasses are used to plot the magnetic field around a bar magnet with poles marked north and south. Which of the following diagrams correctly shows the expected field pattern?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, Priyanshu.
Yes, sir, according to the question, I think number B will be correct because in the book, in our book, Science Booster, that is the arrow marking is showing from south to north, that type suspended magnetic field it is showing. Number B only the correct answer, I think.
From north, now away from the north, the field lines will act, and south towards the south. So, in option B and option C, option D, out of option B and option D, then yes, option D is correct answer. Why? Because you see, you draw this, you draw beta. Okay, if you draw it like from north to south, like this it will be. So here the arrows are this side, from north to south, like this. The arrows are like this. Okay, so option D is the correct answer, but not B.
Okay, sir.
Hope
Okay,
you
sir.
have
Thank you, sir.
understood. Hope you have understood.
Yes, sir.
From north pole to
Yes, sir.
south pole,
Arrow
if you draw
arrow
the
means opposite.
If from the north pole to south pole, if you draw the magnetic field lines, okay, so from north pole they come out and reaches the south pole outside the magnet, and inside the magnet they will go from south pole to north pole. Outside the magnet
Okay, sir.
they will start from north, they will end at south, and inside the magnet south to north. Now Priyanshu, what is your doubt?
No, sir, understood, sir. I am only wrong because, sir, that time I have not followed the question only. Number B pattern I don't observe properly. So I have told number B.
Okay, fine. Any other doubts from anyone? Any doubts from anyone?
Sir.
Huh?
No, sir.
So option D is the correct answer. Then question number two, all of you try once, try.
Yes, sir, we're playing.
Sir, here all the answers
Magnet
are
X is
marked.
lighter than the figure shows a ring magnet X floating above the another ring magnet Y. The like poles of both magnets are facing each other and they repel each other. Yes, option C is the correct answer. Since like poles are facing each other, so that's why you will see there is a repulsion. The next. A student hung a magnet on a spring coil as shown in figure in the diagram. Okay, spring is there and a magnet Y is hung. The next, he held another magnet and the first magnet, he held another magnet under the first magnet as shown. Okay, then what had caused the spring to extend? How, why they will extend?
Sir, because of sir, can I tell?
Tell
Sir,
Priyanshu.
because that magnet is attracting to the another magnet, and so it is means it is
Very good, excellent.
attracting towards the another magnet.
So magnet Q or P are there attraction, there is attraction between those two magnets, so that's why. Yes, very
Yes, sir,
good,
there
excellent.
is no repulsion between them.
Yes, very good, excellent. The next question. Lisa did an experiment to find out which part of the magnet attracts the most pins? P S Q R.
Sir, A.
Which of the following reading is correct regarding the number of pins attracted by different points?
Sir, P and S, it should be more.
Yes, in points it should be more. So P and S, it should be maximum. So maximum number of pins gets attracted at P and S poles, and at other places.
And in between.
It attracts only. Yes, very good, excellent, very good. Manas, any doubt?
That's why the answer is A. I was saying.
Yeah, good, correct. Answer is A. Next. Sohana suspended a bar magnet and a piece of magnetic material on each end of a plastic pole as shown here. She then placed a piece of thin wood between the two objects. Which one of the following diagrams would correctly present the result? Sohana suspended a bar magnet and a piece of magnetic material. Okay. One side magnetic material and other side is magnet. So which one?
Sir.
Would be, which
D.
One?
Sir, can I tell?
D.
Sir, D.
Option D, yeah?
Yes, sir. Because the magnet will attract to the magnetic material.
Magnet will attract to the magnetic material, or magnetic material will attract to the magnet?
Yes, sir. Wood cannot.
The magnetic material will get attracted to the magnet.
Yes, sir. Sir, wood.
Yes.
Sir, I have also done this activity. I don't have taken a thin wood. I have taken a paper, thin paper, and then do this activity. One day I have done this activity, and then it is the magnetic material is at the iron piece is attracted towards the magnet, and I am moving it. Then the magnet, along with the magnet, it is also moving the magnetic material.
Yes, very good. Yes, yes. If you move the magnet, then accordingly the iron material or magnetic material will also move. Yes, correct?
Yes, sir.
So option D is the correct. The next. Ashwini magnetized a piece of iron rod using the stroking method as shown in the diagram. This iron rod. She is rubbing this like this and she is lifting it. Which part of the iron rod becomes the north seeking pole? Which part of the iron rod becomes north seeking pole?
Sir, it will be Q. B. Option
huh?
B. Sir, it will be option B.
Option B, Q.
Sir, option B.
North seeking pole. North seeking pole means what?
Yes, sir. North seeking.
So Q becomes a north pole. So it is just like this. What we have understood in our chapter. Magnetizing the iron bar with a magnet. Point Q. The next. What will happen when three bar magnets are hung in the same manner as shown in figure? So what will happen? X, Y, Z, three magnets. North, south, north,
sir, south, north. X and Y will get attracted. Sir, south and north one will attract, and the south and south will get repulsion.
So X and Y magnets get attracted and Y and Z magnets get repelled.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. X and Y attracts, Y Z repels. Yes, very good. Magnet Y will move towards the magnet X. So option D should be the answer. Very good question. The next. Magnets
sir, number C dropped from a height
repeatedly. Sir, number C.
Yeah. What is your answer, Priyanshu?
Sir, number C. Drops from a height repeatedly.
Magnets lose their properties significantly. Yes. Dropped from a height repeatedly. Yes. Correct. Correct, beta. Magnet loses its property when it dropped from a height. Four bar magnets were hung at different heights from the ground.
Can I say this? Sir, B.
Can I say this one?
B.
It will be hard. So it will be hard.
Based on the diagram, which magnet has the strongest magnetic force if the nails were placed on the ground initially?
Sir, it will be magnet R because it has attracted from the it has attracted most numbers of nails from a very big distance than as compared to others.
In the S magnet, 4 only. In the R magnet, 4 pins. In the Q magnet, 2 pins. In the P magnet, 3 pins. So, R magnet is equally attracting the S magnet, which is very closer. S magnet is which is very closer, it is attracting 4 only. And R magnet is which is very far, it is also attracting 4 pins.
Yes, sir.
So, that means R strongest magnetic force is by R magnet. Yes, very good. Excellent. The next, in which of the following a permanent magnet is not used?
Loudspeakers.
Sir, in loudspeakers there is always loudspeaker magnet.
Yes, very good, excellent. Ahana, in a magnetic door or loudspeaker or compass, everything magnet is used, permanent magnet is used. The answer is none of these.
Yes.
The next. How many north and south poles are present in a magnet if it is broken into 6 pieces without loss of magnetism?
Sir, 12.
Sir, 12.
6 north poles, 6 south poles.
Sir.
Yes, sir, then it will be 12.
Sir, they are total of south poles. 12.
Yeah. North and south, they have asked. So, total will be 12. Yes. The next, two magnets are placed in a container as shown in the figure by some external force. Rajanandani, you are not responding for any question. Rajanandani, are you there, Rajanandani? Yes. Two magnets are placed in a container as shown, okay, by some external force. What would happen if the force on the magnet P is removed? So you are pressing it actually. You are keeping the Q magnet first, and again you are keeping the P magnet first. You are pressing it, you are holding it, and it is stable. But once you remove, the external force, then what would happen?
Sir, it will be option B.
Sir, repel. Option B.
Yeah. It should be option B. Magnet P will repel magnet Q. Okay? Yeah.
Sir.
Because north is placed on north, south is placed on south. Next question.
Sixth question, I think the answer will be option D. Both statements are false. 13th question.
When a horseshoe magnet is brought close to a pile of iron filings, more filings will get attracted to the U-shaped part of the magnet. U-shaped part of the magnet. Horseshoe magnet has only one pole, that is U-shaped part. So actually both are wrong. It is attracted to the north-south. Like north, south poles,
yes, sir.
At poles the attraction is more. Not the
yes, sir, both.
So both the statements are wrong.
Yes, sir. Sir, number D.
The next.
Sir, because.
Which of the following statement is incorrect? Which of the following statements is incorrect?
Sir, that's a C.
To increase the magnetic strength, increase the number of strokes while creating magnets. To increase the magnetic strength, increase the number of coils around the nail. Magnetic force is a pulling force only. Magnet may lose its magnetic property when heated to a very A, B, D are correct. Magnetic force is a pulling force only. That is wrong. It is also pushing force. Because there is an attraction as well as repulsion is also there. Okay?
Yes, sir.
The next. Which of the following is the best way to stroke or keep magnets?
Option number D. Soft iron means keepers. Keepers.
Very good. Very good. Excellent. Swapnanil, correct. Option D. It should be option D.
Soft iron, we can place the iron magnets in a waste way. That is known as keepers.
Yes, yes. Okay. So this achiever section, I don't know whether we may finish or not. So